Hi, good morning children. Welcome back to our session. So yesterday's class we have seen about the what's the topic? Thrust, pressure, Archimedes principle. Is it? Yeah. What's our chapter? It's gravitation chapter. Is it no children? Yes. So in this today we are going to solve the problem regarding to the thrust and the pressure. Here is your problem. Let me see. A block of wood is kept on a table top. So some wood is kept on a table top. The mass of wooden block is 5 kg. How much it weighs? 5 kg. And its dimensions are 40 cm, 20 cm, 10 cm. What do you mean by the dimensions, children? If you take a block, so for this we will be having the 3 dimensions. Here this is the length, this is the width, and this will be the height. So what is that? The 3 dimensions are 40 cm, 20 cm, 10 cm. Then find the pressure exerted by the wooden block on the table top of it is made to lie on the table top with its sides of the dimension. What we have to find? We have to find the pressure. Finished? No, still. Then if the dimensions are, it has changed the dimensions. 20 cm into 10 cm, 1. Next, 40 cm into 20 cm. So this is our problem. We have to solve. Okay, let me start. Yeah. So first, what it has given, let me write down. What it has given, children? The mass of the wooden plank. How much? 5 kg. Whose mass is that? Mass of the wooden plank. Then, what are the dimensions? How much? 40 centimeter into 20 cm into 10 cm. 40 cm into 20 cm into 10 cm. Okay. Then, what is the thrust? F is equal to mg. Thrust, F is equal to mg. Substitute the value. F is equal to what is the mass? 5 kg into. What is the G value? I have given the capital G in the examination. Few of the children, they have not at all mentioned the value of capital G. Capital G is universal law of gravitation. Here we are asking the G. That is acceleration due to gravity. It is having its value. It is 9.8 meter per second square. 5 into 9.8 meter square. So multiply, children. 5 8s are 40, 5 9s are 45, 45 plus 4, 49. So what are the units for the force? It is the Newton. So how much we got now? 49 Newtons. Then we have to find the area. What we have to find? We have to find the area. So how this dimensions given? Length, breadth and height. So it is like the rectangle. It is like the rectangle. So what is the formula for a rectangle? That means area of side is length into breadth. Is it? Yes. So length into breadth. How much is length? 20 centimeter. And what is the breadth? 10 centimeter. 20 into 10 centimeters. How much will you get? 20 into 10, nothing but 200 centimeters. So convert this centimeters into meters, children. How much? How much will you get? How much will you get? 20, 200 centimeters is equal. equal to 0.02 meters. Meter square. Centimeter into centimeter, centimeter square. So if you convert 0.02 meter square, what is this? Area of a side. Next, we have to find the pressure. Okay. What is the formula for the pressure? Already we have learned. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. So already we got the thrust value here. How much? 49 units. Then we got the area also. 0.02 meter square. So substitute here. How much? 49 newtons by 0.02 meter square. Remove the zeros. So how much will get? 4900 by 2. Do the calculation, children. 2 ones are 2 fours are 2 fives. How much we got? 2 twos are 4 2 fours are 8. Carry 1 10. So 2 fives are yes. So how much we got? 2450. What are the units? Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. That's all. Finished? No. Still another area also it has given for us. So what is that? Area of a side. That is 40 centimeters. At last they have asked to find out for us. 20 centimeters. 40 centimeters into 20 centimeters. Multiply, children. 4 2's are 8. So 800 centimeters is nothing but 0.08 meters square. 0.08 meter square. So for this we have to find the pressure. Same thing, pressure is equals to thrust by area. Substitute the value. So much we got the thrust now. Already we have find it. The thrust is 49 newtons by, now what we have find it, the area. Area is 0.08 meter square. So remove the zeros. 4900 by 8. That is equal to 8 6 are 48 49 10 8 1s are 8 20 8 4 8 3s are 8 2s are 16 40 5 newton meter per square. So how much we got here? 612.5 newton meter square. So what they have asked, the pressure extracted by the side of 20 into 10 is how much we got? 2450 newton per meter square. And the pressure extracted by 40 into 20, we got the pressure as 612.5 newton per meter square. Okay, so this is the solution of the given problem regarding to the thrust and the pressure. Have you understood? Yes. So copy down to your homework notebook. Next, let me go for our next topic. Okay. Next, our topic is relative density. So in your previous classes, you have learnt about the density. What do you mean by density, children? Density is nothing but mass per volume. What the given mass it has given divided by its volume, if you have taken, will get the density. And the units are kg per meter cube, is it? But today's our topic is relative. Relative is nothing but finding out the ratio between of those given substance. Let me see, what is that? The density. What do you mean by the density? The density of a substance is defined as mass per unit volume. What is that? The density of a substance is defined as mass per unit volume. Then, what is the relative density? The relative density substance express the heaviness or density of the substance in comparison of water. So here we are comparing by using of the water. So actually density means mass per volume. The units are kg per meter cube. Then what do you mean by the relative density? Relative density is density of a substance per density of the water. So what are the units for this? There are no units, because here the relative density is the ratio of the similar quantities. The ratio of the similar quantities. So there is no unit for the relative density. Is it? Yes. So this is about the density and relative density. Copy down to your running notes, children. It's very important. Regarding this, let me see a small video and then let me stop of this session. Okay? Thank you.
Everyone, do you know what floats and what sinks in water? Let us understand the factor that decides it. We say iron is heavier than wood. Here we are not mentioning the objects in comparison. A big wooden furniture is heavier than a small iron ball, right? So in the language of science, it means density of iron is more than the density of wood. And density, as we know, is mass per unit volume. So this means mass of 1 cubic centimeter or 1 cubic meter of iron is more than that of the wood of the same volume. Now, to find the density of a substance, we need to find the volume and the mass of the substance, as density is mass divided by volume. Now, the unit of mass is gram or kg, and the unit of volume is cubic centimeter or cubic meters. So the unit of density is either gram per cubic centimeter or its kg per cubic meter. Here we say the SI unit of density is kg per cubic meter. You know, there is a very simple way to find the density of an object which you can follow even at home. First, let's find the weight of the object. Next, we take an overflow vessel like this and fill it to the maximum. The best way to ensure that it is filled to the maximum is to fill it until it overflows. And then we wait until water stops dripping from the peak. Now it is absolutely full. Next, we take a measuring cylinder under the beak. Now we put the object gently into the vessel with the help of a string. When fully immersed, the object will displace water which is equivalent to its volume. We collect that water in the measuring beaker and weigh it. Generally, we measure the mass or the weight of empty measuring beaker beforehand, say it was W1. And then we weigh it with water, say it is equal to W2. So W2 minus W1 is the mass of water whose volume is the same as the volume of the object. And this is because the object has displaced this water when it was fully immersed in water. Now, comparing these two weights or masses gives us the relative density of the object, that is the ratio of the density of the object to the density of water. How? Density is mass per unit volume. Now here, volume of displaced water is same as the volume of object. So we say the two volumes are equal and they cancel each other. So the formula we get is mass of object divided by mass of water of same volume or equal volume, and that is exactly what we did. So relative density of an object is the ratio of its density and density of water, which is equal to the ratio of its mass and the mass of water of equal volume. And this is very easy to find. That was all about relative density. Bye-bye.